Awake. Just about. Shower. Coffee? Black. The milk's gone off. Is it buried in the pile or still in the dryer? Who's to say? Better hurry up and check the time.
Fuck. Fuck.
Train? 901? Can't miss this. Hurry up, please. Train? 901. Can't miss this. Hurry up, please. There we go.
Bridging the gap between the modernists and the postmodernists, Beckett's Waiting for Godot reveals Neer and Estragon are joined by a single dead tree on stage, a desolate mise-en-scène, reflective of a desolate, with the line, nothing to be done. There is simply nothing to be done before Godot. Charlie?
I was not.
Yes, you were.
Well, it was pretty boring, though.
No.
It's not that. It's just like... Just like what?
It's just difficult to, like, you know, like, always understand everything that's going on.
What, are you, like, depressed or something?
You can't say that.
No. It's not that. It's just, like, difficult to be there, like, all the time, like, mentally.
Where'd you go?
I don't know.
Here we go again. Shower quickly. Coffee, still no milk. Clothes. Where are they? Train, Charlie, come on. Lecture. Pay attention, Charlie. These are your friends. Come on. Laugh, Charlie. Alarm. Shower. Coffee. Clothes. Train. Lecture. Friends.
Each with their own interpretation of what it is and what makes it important. For Hegel, explains that the absurdity of religious truths prevents us from reaching God by action.
well-being here is paramount, and we want to support you to achieve the best that you can do.
Yes, if there's anything we can do, please contact us during our office hours, or reach out at...
Some top tips from us?
Yes, some tip-top tips!
Top tip number one, have you drank enough water today?
Water?
Yes, water, it's good for the body. Good for the mind.
Good for the soul.
Good for the mind, the body, the soul.
Wait, what are they?
Top tip number two.
Are you getting enough sleep?
Oh, we love sleep. I know I have to get my 8 hours in. In fact, I think someone's sleeping right now.
No, I...
Oh, you silly goose. We're only joking. In fact... That leads us right onto top tip number three.
Top tip number three, of course, laughter.
Laughter is the best medicine.
That it is.
Hey, would you like to hear a joke?
Oh, would I?
Right, right. What did the fish say when he swam into the wall?
Gosh, I don't know. What did the fish say when he swam into a wall?
Damn! Gosh. They really must be struggling, not laughing at the old classic.
I don't hear your jokes, right? I just want your help. What you've said is all well and good, but I've tried it all before and it hasn't helped. And I just want your help. I have this constant like fogginess.
Wait, you've tried drinking more water?
Yeah.
Getting more sleep?
Yeah.
And laughter?
Yes, and it hasn't helped.
Wait, Sarina. Water, sleep, laughter...
Listen. I've tried to do some research, and I think it might be this thing where your brain has trouble processing things going on around you.
That sounds like you're just making it up.
Yeah, doesn't sound real to me.
Have you ever heard of it before?
No. Have you?
No. I bet they just want an excuse for when they forget to do something.
Or to try and get extra time for assignments.
Or maybe even when they...
Oh.
It's a funny one. The human mind. It works so hard to protect itself. Because apparently this is protection. This is what it's calculated to be better than every single other behaviour it could possibly tell me to do right now. Better than facing the world as it really is. I mean, I'm not a psychologist. I don't exactly know what's going on up there a lot of the time, but the way I make sense of it is this. That the mind chooses to cut out everything else, just for a little bit. It decides not to process anything that is happening beyond the boundaries of itself. It says, nope, none of this. I'd like to get through what's happening up here, if you don't mind, and I'll get back to you shortly. Because the world can be too much sometimes. I think that's something everyone feels, but our brains choose to handle it differently than the other brains out there. A lot of the time it's something that happens beyond my control and I have to be like, oh shit, here we go again. How long is it going to last for this time? And that can be absolutely terrifying. At first, it was something I kind of liked, in a weird way. It was a break from everything that was going on. Like, all the shit being crammed in suddenly wasn't there anymore. And for a little bit, at least, things could slow down. It was peaceful. Albeit a warped, hazy version of peace. Though, of course, nothing was really gone. All my problems were still there, being made worse by the fact that I was like this, and living like this is, well, it's hardly living at all. Even if it might be necessary in the moment. The sad thing is that a lot of this is rooted in some sort of trauma. I won't go into mine, but as a trans lesbian with a Catholic upbringing, I'll let you put the pieces together on that one. From all that I've read, there's no cure. You know, they talk about grounding techniques, like naming the colours that you see and the sensations that you feel, but against the might of your own brain, that's often not enough. You know, you're at the mercy of your own psyche and you have to hold on and endure whatever it throws your way until it decides to release you. It's a lot. Though, in all of this, it's made me appreciate the times that I am here. There's this new beauty in life that wasn't there before. The beauty in each moment. Because we all have a limited number of moments. Far fewer we can take the time to actually appreciate. But when you get a good moment and hold on to it, that is what makes life worth living. It's spending time with good people, the coffees, the catch-ups, the 2 a.m. deep chats, it's the late nights and early mornings and wooded walks where you feel like you're the only person in the world. Nature really helps. It's facing each struggle and making it to the other side and laughing and loving before we do it all over again. It's making the most of my little finite existence on this godforsaken rock floating through space. I want to look back and see I made the most of it all. of my limited number of moments because fucking hell have I worked too hard for too long not to make the most of this life. I am the rotting fruit in my fridge. I am the static in my head. I am this lump of flesh on my bed. In the room, but somewhere else. Just beyond my field of view, just out of reach, and I need to be okay with that. Or at least be able to deal with that. Not long from now, I will re-enter my brain and pick things back up where we left them. I'll work and write and do all of the things that make me happy and some of the things that make me a little bit sad but need to be done. And I'll make the most of my limited number of moments in the times that I can. And that will be enough. There's a lot I don't understand about any of this. I try and deal with it on a day-to-day basis, or an episode-to-episode basis, but one thing I do know is that I'm not alone in feeling like this.
What does dissociation mean to you?
Sometimes rest, sometimes complete terror. There's no in between.
I think over time, I've moved to see it as a self-protection mechanism and appreciate it more as my brain doing what it needs to keep me safe how it can.
The experience of feeling outside of myself.
Having everything that you are and everything that you think be completely separate from everything you do.
Losing touch with reality.
I used to describe it when I was younger as like being just outside of my mind. Now, I recognise that it's an old trauma response.
For me, it's very connected to anxiety and panic attacks. It's a total feeling of disconnect and makes things feel unreal.
Feeling mentally absent in a room full of people.
Suffering, loss, peace, absurdity.
How do you feel during a state of dissociation?
It's like you're existing in the other side of a really shit mirror. And all the feelings and experiences you've been having are on the real side, so you can see them but don't have to touch them anymore. Because
You're kind of trapped away from them, whether you want to be or not.
It feels like becoming an observer of yourself, rather than being in control. Almost like panning out into a third-person view.
Something like an extreme daydream?
Like walking late into a party. Everybody's already split into their respective groups, chatting and going about. You can't find your place.
Like nothing is real, and I'm disconnected from the world around me.
Like when you're in the eye of a tornado and everything around is spinning and going on, and your head is just calm.
Everything looks like it's in the uncanny valley.
Like a glass of water. Like everything's going through me to be seen by other people, and I still interact with what's happening, but I barely have control over it. It just passes through me and gets slightly distorted.
I get very anxious. As soon as I've noticed that things don't seem right, I panic. A lot. Which in turn makes me lightheaded or dizzy.
I feel like a big cloud of fog has entered my brain. And like I've exited my body and I'm hovering just outside of it.
Fucking drained, man.
I go a bit numb, but also it feels a bit like the skin that's exposed is seeping out of me and into the surroundings.
Extreme apathy. I'm not engaging in feeling anything. More of an absence of feeling than an actual feeling.
Kind of being out of your mind. Like, things are happening and you're aware of them happening, but you're not present in the moment.
Is dissociation a negative thing for you? What are the worst things?
I'm not present, and I'm a burden, but I can't control it.
I think the fear that other people who don't want to notice will notice.
Oh, it's definitely a negative thing for me, because it's so closely linked to panic attacks.
Being uncomfortably calm.
The worst aspect is probably when it affects my perception of time. There have been a few times when I've woken up in the middle of the night and it just felt like everything I did was too fast and unnatural.
Feeling like a prisoner in your own mind is one of the most distressing and scariest things I've ever been through.
Generally, I believe it's your body saying, this is a bad situation, we need to get you out of it now, which is all fine and good when you're in a situation where you can stop doing the task and just be fine, but sometimes you need to do things you just don't want to do.
The only negative thing related to it for me is not an effect of dissociation itself, more of that it is an indicator of how depressed or lonely I am, as I feel like those things are often, but not always, requirements for it to happen in the first place.
It can be negative when it is non-consensual. Yeah, it feels like a violation.
How do you go about managing or controlling or stopping it?
Other people snap me back. Like when my name is said to get my attention or someone clicks in front of my eyes.
Distraction is definitely the easiest way. Watching a TV show that I've seen before and is very easy to follow can help.
With grounding techniques, like petting my cat.
I haven't got that far.
I don't. I let it be.
I think with enough mental will, you can sometimes snap out of that state. Otherwise, you need something to externally pull you out, like having alarms on your phone or someone to check on you.
Practicing meditation, mindfulness, and trying to live consciously in the present moment. Also surrounding myself with people and supporting myself in a way in which my psyche feels safe and supported.
I've never found a good way of managing.
And finally, is it positive in any way for you?
Sometimes it feels like a relief. If I can't calm myself down, my body does it for me, and the feeling of dissociating is better than the feeling it's avoiding.
No.
It's a good teller of when I have reached an energetic boundary. If I notice that I dissociate, then it helps me gauge that I have mentally or emotionally had enough and need to take some time out to reconnect.
If I'm mentally tired and on my own, it helps to relieve some exhaustion, as I don't have to think about much.
Not really.
I think it's a useful warning sign that you need to stop what you're doing or
find another way of achieving it.
Yeah, it's better than having continuous panic attacks.
Peaceful is a good way to describe it when it's working perfectly.
Your life, yeah, mine's all right. Oh, I'm doing fine.
It's just life, honey.
Well, hey, I'm having a bad day, so tell me it's okay. Sometimes it's just that way. Mama said the grass is always greener where you water it. Go and fill your diet up with greens and reds and oranges. Coffee goes cold, so you better drink all of it. Go and live your life, cause you know you were born for it. You are not an image or a product or commodity. You aren't worth more because you like to eat broccoli. You're made up of your thoughts, habits, hopes, fears, and honestly, you're floating through space on a rock. Ain't that crazy? Your life, what could go wrong? Hey, so I fell on my face when I was walking through town earlier today. But then I stayed down, laying on the ground, cause everyone looks so happy when they're upside down. And it got me wondering, what is this all about? We're just kids in the playground and the sun goes out. Where are my instructions? What am I here to do? An existential crisis at 22. My mama said the grass is always greener where you wanna be. You got to learn to love the ground you're standing on already. And coffee goes cold, but be grateful that there's any. Go and live your life, cause you've always been ready. You are not an image or a product or commodity. You aren't worth more because you like to eat.